Have you ever thought of building your own website or starting a website development service? Well, thankfully, there's a bunch of theme builders out there that we can just get started right away. In this video, I will be showing you how to get started with Xylem Builder. I will be covering how to install WordPress, how to install the Xylem Builder plugin, and how to get started with templates on Xylem Builder. Now, we gotta thank our sponsor for this video, which is Hostinger. They provided the share hosting that we're going to use, and I'm going to show you how to install WordPress with them. So it's gonna be all a breeze with this video. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. All right, before we get started with our WordPress installation, I just want to show you our sponsor's prices for their shared hosting, because it's a pretty great price. What I'm using is the premium shared hosting, and it's $199 a month when you commit to them for a few years. So great prices, great limits, and obviously great speed. The next deal that we have is Xylem Builder. That is what I'm going to use. And it's $99 for the lifetime deal. The cool part about this is that I'm going to show you what it includes. It has unlimited websites. What does that mean? Well, I can use this builder to start building websites for myself and for clients. You get unlimited domains, white labeling, pro library, and pro Xylem Builder elements. So you get the whole pack with this for $99. Okay, let's get started with our Xylem Builder. This is our main panel for Xylem Builder, and the first thing that we're going to need is the latest plugin for Xylem Builder, which is this one as of this video, which is 2.2.7.4. All right, so I already downloaded that. I have it ready, and the next thing that we're going to need is the license key once we install it. So let's head on over to our Hostinger shared hosting, and it's super easy to get started. Let's scroll down to our auto installer. Let's go here. And we're going to install WordPress. Heads up, if you plan to build a store, install WooCommerce. So in this case, we're gonna use WordPress, and I am going to use a subcategory. What does that mean? That I'm not going to use the main domain because this is just for testing purposes. But if you want to use the main domain, keep this blank. So in this case, I will use Xylem. So that's going to be the subfolder for this subcategory. Next thing I'll have to put here is a username and password. Let me type in a password for this really quickly. Okay, the language for this site is English, and the latest WordPress is going to be installed. Like I said, as of this video, it's 5.8.2. Yes, create a new database, and we'll keep database, let them generate the password. Okay, it's going to install the latest PHP, which is 8.0. Let's go ahead and install. Oh, the website title, my bad. We'll call this Xylem. Let's go ahead and install it. Okay, our installation is ready. Here we go. We have our website right here. Let's go ahead and jump to our site. Let me copy this link really quickly. And let's go ahead and open it. Here we go. We have a blank WordPress site, just like that. So now let's go into our WordPress admin panel. Let's go into wp-admin. Okay, here we go. We're logged in. For this demo, we are going to deactivate some plugins. So we're going to keep it clean because we are going to focus on Xylem Builder. So let me remove these for now. Okay, let me deactivate this. Let's apply it. And what we're going to do now is install the Xylem Builder plugin. Remember, we're in the plugin section. We're going to click on add new. We're going to upload a plugin. We're going to choose a file. In this case, I mentioned already, I have a download. So let's go ahead and click install now. Okay, it's been installed. Let's go ahead and activate it. And it's going to prompt us to also install the Xylem Builder Pro. So let's install the Xylem Builder Pro really quickly here. Let's go ahead and activate the plugin. Here we go, it's activated. And on our left, we have the Xylem Builder menu. Let's go into Xylem Builder. We're gonna go into our Pro license key, and let's go back into our Xylem panel to grab that license. So here we go, let's go into license key. I'm going to copy the license key, and I'm gonna head on over to my WordPress site, add my key, and there we go. It's activated for life. It's going to update. It's going to do everything for life without having to pay nothing else. All right. So what's next? In my recommendations, I would head on over to appearance, customize. I would go to colors because we're gonna get rid of that awful green and we're gonna go into white. Here we go, let's go ahead and publish, go back, okay? And next step is pages. Let's add a brand new page. We're gonna call this home, and the template that we're going to use is Xylem Builder Full Width. Next thing we're gonna do is click on Edit with Xylem Builder. It's gonna open up the Xylem Builder now. There we go. And now we are ready to edit with Xylem Builder. My recommendation is I would get started here, library. We can use headers to install really quickly. We can use sections if we wanna build by our own, each one of these sections if as of we need it. So there's content, counter, devices, footer, headers, and all of that good stuff. I'm avoiding the last one because that's where we're going to get started. Core UI, you can see there's a lot of options and we can use these to build our website. Blue UI, more elements, newspaper, lots of elements, and the one we're gonna use are templates. So there's several templates available here. We can preview them, we can select them, we can say, hey, you know what? I like this one, and we can select it. Again, we can add the template and then we can add more elements from these. So you don't have to get stuck with any of these. So I'll select this one and we'll say, hey, you know what? That looks nice. I like it. The preview, I'm good. Let's go ahead and insert. There we go. It's been inserted. Now we have this little header here. We're gonna go into page options and we are going to use blank Canva. There we go. Now it's blank Canva. We have a nice looking website already loaded. Now, before I show you how the elements work and how we can get started with editing, I just want to show you first how this is going to preview on a live page, okay? Let's go ahead and click on this little check mark and we're going to save and publish. Let's go back into our admin panel. The reason I'm taking you to admin panel is because if we go to the homepage right now, it's this one. It's not the one we created right now. So what we're gonna do is set the homepage that we just created. So let's go into settings. Sorry, it's the reading. And we're gonna select static page if it's not selected. And we're going to select the page we've just created. In my case, I called it home, but if you've named it something else, you just select it. Let's go ahead and save it. And now our homepage should be the one we just created. Let's go ahead and refresh. There we go. Our homepage is now updated with this template that we just added. That was fast and easy. Let's go ahead and close it. We're back to our builder. And now we're going to customize this template. Like I mentioned before, it's super easy to get started. We've loaded the template. Now we're going to customize. Now, recommendations, obviously we're going to replace images because they are the template images. We want to use our own. My recommendation is that when you select an image, make sure that the images that you are using are optimized. That way we keep the Xylem Builder neat, lean, and fast, okay? Because as is this right now, it's default, it's fast. But if we start bloating it with images then that are not optimized, we can slow it down. So when I double click on an element, we're able to edit and it's gonna open up the options on the left. Any element that I select, for example, I'm gonna select this text, I'm gonna click the pencil, and it's gonna open up the editor for this section that I've just clicked, okay? I can go ahead and update it from here. So if I remove this, it's gonna update it just by typing on it. Let's just say update. Okay, there we go, we just updated that. Obviously we're going to replace things that we don't want to use. Now these are the elements and we have obviously the section. If I want to edit the whole section, let me click on that pencil, there we go. This is the section settings. So we have sections, elements, columns. The styling for this, so there's wallpaper for this. If we want to edit these, we can edit a lot of things. Here's the image that we're previewing. We can remove it and we can add a solid color to it. We can blend colors. We can do a lot of things. I won't get too specific because there's too many options and obviously we all have different needs. So I want to show you the getting started, okay? So there's the element, okay? Like I mentioned before, when we click on the pencil, it opens up the settings on the left. We also have the tree view. Let me open up right here. The Tribute, let me close that, will take us to the sections that we've added. For example, section 6, it'll scroll right to section 6, and we have two elements, two or three. Looks like three. I'll open up the elements right here, and we have two columns, okay? And in this column, we have two text elements. So you can see right here, and if I hover over them, it's gonna select it. So it makes it super easy to edit and replace elements with this type of builder. Now, I can actually drag and drop these if I like. So for example, we have these two text boxes. If I move it to the bottom, now we have this text on the bottom instead of top. Let's bring it to the top again. And we can do that also with sections and columns. So for example, columns, we have these two columns. If I move it, there we go, we switched it around. If I wanna move the column somewhere else, we can do so also. Or we can do it physically, drag and drop. So for example, if this image, if I wanted it down here, I can do so that way. If I want it over here, I can do it also. If I wanna drag the bottom one to this place, we can do it that way. There's a lot of things that we can do. There's also spacing. So right now we did some movement that kind of moved it around here. Well, we can drag this to give it the space again. So it looks good. Instead of looking all clunky, well, we can add spacing to them in several forms. Also spacing for these elements. See these? We can add sections. So if we want to add a brand new section, you see this little blue icon. I click on it and we can add layouts. So I can add layouts depending on the divisions that I need. So if I need, oh, status error, I'll click on that. If I need a double element because I want to add two images like the one we saw right now, I can do so. I can add 4, 5, and just depending on how we need that distribution is how we're going to use it. There's also these type of elements, sections, columns, sliders, containers, model, and library. Again, library takes us here. And if we needed something like, let's see, pro sections. If we needed something like, I don't know, let's see, pricing tables. Well, we have some elements here. I'll insert a pricing table. There we go. And this element doesn't look like it's in the right place because I put it in the bottom. So I am going to move it around. I'll put it in the second one. So let's go all the way up. And our pricing table is right here just by adding elements. So you're kind of getting the idea of how it's easy to start editing a website either by loading in a template, editing the elements, replacing them actually, because you're working with a template, or starting from zero by adding these sections, which is pretty easy from our library. We also have the section view, wireframe. If you kind of don't find something, wireframe helps you find that view right there. Our library, which we saw already, we have all these available. If we made a mistake, we have our history. So these are the movements that we've made when we're editing right now. If I made a mistake that I want to replace and I remember, hey, you know what? It was like 4 minutes ago. Well, I click on it and it'll go back to where we kept it, right? Now, if I hover over it, it's gonna tell us what it did. Moved image, section 8 margin, and all of that. We have desktop view, laptop view, mobile view, in case we want to preview it, how it's going to look on mobile view, and kind of edit this mobile view to find out if this is how we want to use it. All right, let's go back into desktop view. We have our page option settings. You saw how I replaced the section right now. Right now, the page status is as draft. Okay, we have the starter tour if you want to get started there, and our save template if you want to use this again for another section on your website, save pages, and save and publish. So it's super easy to get started. Now in this video, I showed you how to install WordPress, install Xylem Builder, and get started with templates. Now it's ready for you to get started and play around. Search what you're going to need specifically because you will have specific needs for your own website building. Again, let's thank our shared hosting sponsored for this, which is Hostinger. Remember, they have a really good price for shared hosting. The links will be in the description for Xylem Builder and Hostinger's shared hosting plans. Well, I thank you for watching. My name's George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.